other than building the perfect social media profile. Flattering photos, funny yet relatable captions, videos of dogs. I never really thought that I could build anything. That's until I met Emily Pilloton. She showed me that anyone can build.
I'm not wired to work in an office. I'm not wired to do work that I don't get to put my name on. So when I was 26, I quit and I founded a nonprofit, and I've been doing that work ever since. And that's the way that I fell in love with architecture and building, and also the way I came to understand who I am as a person. And I think every young person deserves to have experiences like that.
Emily created a place called Girls Garage in Berkeley, California, where she's teaching young girls to build confidence in themselves through engineering and math. Let's build.
Hi.
So nice. Welcome.
Thank you so much. I have to say, this place is incredible.
This is a place where we teach carpentry, welding, architecture, and screen printing classes to young girls. We do all kinds of awesome building projects together.
So what are we going to build today?
So I thought it was fitting that if we're talking about tools and girl power and power tools, we need our very own toolbox. It's a great first project because it promotes even more building, but it's also a really cool object that helps us understand the basics of how things are put together. I think that learning how to build things is a great way for girls to build both physical confidence in their bodies, as well as connecting math and science and other STEM skills to something real and something tangible that lives in the world. So before we do anything though, anytime we're in a shop, we gotta do a safety check.
Safety glasses? Check. Long pants? Check. Closed-toed shoes? Check. Hair tied back? Check.
Do not ever operate tools unless you have an adult supervisor buddy present who knows how to operate them safely.
Lucky for me, I do, so we're gonna do this.
Let's do it. So the first step for really any project is to measure out and cut our pieces out of wood.
You obviously know a lot about building. What got you interested in it to begin with?
When I was a teenager, I had this awesome opportunity to travel to Central America with a group of other teenagers, and we built a gazebo and this whole town park area, and it was through that project that I learned that I love building, and I'm really good at it, and it was something that I wanted to do really for the rest of my life.
At first, these tools seem scary, but the motto at Girls Garage is fear less, build more. And trust me, if I can do it, so can you.
Amazing!
Whoa! That was so cool!
With my first cut made, Emily tries to stump me with a question.
Why can't I just measure 16 and a half and then 12 and then 12?
And cut them all at once.
And cut them all at once. So why can't we do that?
If I had to guess, it's because since that's an eighth of an inch, we are gonna lose some wood on either side of that measurement, right?
You're so natural. Yep. So if we had done that, our last cut would end up a quarter of an inch short.
You're using a lot of math here.
Absolutely. Every single decision we're making here has some kind of mathematical justification.
How does building something like this help you in other aspects of life?
I think you learn so much from building when things don't go quite the way you expect, and
sure,
you have to figure out how to make it work. Okay, this one's for all the glory.
All the glory. This one's for all my fans. All two of them, mom and dad, here we go.
Yes! So good.
Mission accomplished.
All right, you did it.
Oh,
you built the toolbox.
This is so cool.
Now you have to fill it with your own tools and go build more stuff.
I'm planning on doing that right now. I've got a whole apartment that needs a lot of help in New York City.
Thanks to Emily Pilloton for showing me that with a little math and engineering, I can build confidence in myself.
Great job.
Thank you.